making decisions and everything. I just appreciate your service, and I appreciate this opportunity for common people to have a voice. And I just have a very brief few comments to say. It's about the jail, and the jail is certainly not my specialty. I don't have a dog in the fight at all, although I am going to New York City in a couple weeks to distribute Bibles in Rikers Island. So I'm kind of looking forward to that.
You need more excitement, Jackie.
But my comments are, I went to the presentation by the New Bern commissioner about their new jail, and Larry Britt had that meeting. It was very informative. And what came up, though, is after they built the beautiful new jail, they were asked to build a courthouse. And they didn't plan on that, and they weren't happy about it, but that was what they thought was needed. And so I'm just thinking about building. Now, we might need a new jail. I'm not going to argue that. But where are we going to build it? And it worries me if we build it out of the city that the next thing, oh, we'll need a courthouse. And the next thing, oh, well, there's probably the sheriff department ought to be close because that needs a new building anyway. And then the lawyers will be setting up their little offices. And I just feel that if you move the jail out of town, it'll take the heart out of the city. And it'll be a decline of our city economy. And I know it might be just an obvious opinion, but I just felt I wanted to mention it and share it, because I don't think that would be a wise thing to do. And I thought there was something else I wanted to say, but I can't think of it right now. Oh, yeah. I hate to consider the jail as being the heart of the city, but the administration of justice is the heart of government. So there is a connection, and I think that's in our founding documents, that that's the purpose of government, to administer justice. And so I just want you to just think about that as you make this crucial decision. And I thank you so much for your attention.
All right, thank you. Dr. Phipps, excuse me, Mr. Chairman, I think we need to go back and
Good evening, gentlemen. I'd like to give you a current update on the repairs that have been done to the courthouse as well as the jail. Once again, I've prepared a PowerPoint, which I think Jim is queuing up right now, just to kind of keep the same format that we've looked at for the past couple of months. We have made great strides. Yes, sir?
Did you ever send out the last PowerPoint?
It was in the meeting minutes.
It was in your board packet, I believe.
In the board packet?
The previous one, correct. But I'll get you another copy.
Is it possible to send them out earlier?
Yeah.
I can send it out to you tomorrow morning.
That's fine.
Is that good?
It was not received in time to go in your agenda packet, so it was not in your packet. It is, however, in your certified minutes.
Okay. From the last meeting.
Yes, sir.
No, it's prepared right up to the minute. I made corrections just a few minutes before I came in. Because, as I was saying, we have made tremendous strides in the past 30 days working to make the repairs that we needed for the courthouse. First slide, Jim. I'm, like I said, trying to keep the same format. The current issues that we'll discuss this evening is providing emergency power to the essential systems of the jail. Second item is discussion of the courthouse switchgear. Third item is returning the dryer to service. Fourth item is discussing the interior improvements that have been made to the jail. And the fifth item is discussion of the public elevator. Providing emergency power to the essential systems of the jail, I'm extremely happy to report that the 50 kW generator and associated automatic transfer switch have been installed. Both the local inspector as well as a team of three inspectors today from the Department of Health and Human Services have inspected the installation. The inspectors from Department of Health and Human Services verbally told me that they accept the installation and that they will be issuing a report within the next couple of days to that fact. And there is one small issue with the control wire with the generator that I've been in contact with the contractor this afternoon, and I have hopes it will be corrected tomorrow. So before we receive the paperwork, the formal field report, we should have all of the issues resolved. Courthouse switchgear. Due to the cost to repair the existing switchgear, the decision was made to replace the old switchgear with new breaker panels. This work was designed by Engineering Source of North Carolina, and it was completed by Watson Electric. This work was completed this past Friday evening, and it was a successful project. They started work at 6 p.m. and completed the repairs at about 2 a.m., and we had the final inspection at 6 a.m. on Saturday morning. The City of Washington was very accommodating with us, their inspections department, to be there to get us so that we could return the building to service as quickly as possible. Next item is returning the dryer to service. Once again, I'll preface this as I have each time previously. This is not something that has to be complete to return the inmates to the facility, but we're still working to get it complete. Engineering Source of North Carolina submitted the plans to modify the building systems to DHS for approval. DHS, the reviewers, wanted to actually look at the site, so we did that today, and we discussed the project in detail. And once again, they gave us verbal approval of that project. So we are actually beginning work on that this afternoon, because once again, understanding the urgency and also understanding that it is much easier to get workers in the jail to do the work without inmates in.
Does that have to do with ventilation?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. The fourth item, I believe. It's okay, Jim, you can go to the next. The interior improvements of the jail. If you recall, I was tasked with, while the inmates are out, trying to complete as much maintenance work in the jail that we can with the inmates being moved out. So we did complete the painting of the interior of the jail. Plumbing repairs have also been made, and this is one of the exceptions, the corrections I made just before. I had been told previously that all of them had been corrected, but going back through, double-checking things, there is still one shower. The shower does function. It just doesn't function correctly, appropriately at all times, but you can still turn the water on and turn the water off with the valves, but there's still some plumbing work that needs to be done on that one particular shower. Once again, it would not prevent inmates from being in there. Those are conditions that we will continually work with. The next item is the slide regarding the cost for the past couple of months. And Jim pulled this information together, working with the Sheriff's Department and also Maintenance Department. And I'll let Jim discuss this.
Mr. Chairman, we broke these down into different levels as we reported and estimated previously. Staffing, which is your overtime with the sheriff's office and jail for the 3 months. Overtime is paid once a month. It's paid on the 15th of the month, and it's paid for the month prior. So the first month, the month of July, which would have been July 15th payroll, was paid for June overtime, which you'll recall, I believe June 8th was the shutdown. So it accumulated. So the actual July overtime was for the first month of the event, the shutdown event. And this represents July, August, and estimate what it'll be for August. So it'll be June, July, and August estimate. Inmate housing, of course, this is still somewhat of an estimate because we don't have all the invoices yet, but we definitely have the amount of inmates housed and where they were housed at. And Captain Ross gave me some good data to calculate this figure on travel costs. This is somewhat of a difficult one to estimate as well, but the Sheriff's Office has done a fairly decent job in providing detail of trips and so forth, and to get us this estimate. Of course, the maintenance cost, which includes those items that Christina has discussed. The only item that is not included in this estimate is the cost of painting. The reason for that is because that was a budgeted item that we had discussed doing already, so we did not want to lump that together. It was done, it was budgeted for, but it was not included as a cost of jail shutdown per se, because it didn't amount to a need for that shutdown. Some of the regular maintenance that was done is included in this figure, and but the jail painting was not.
The last item is regarding the public elevator, which I'm also happy to report that that project is complete. So the public elevator is back in service. It was out for the month of August, but it was returned to service on September 3rd, 2013. So we're hoping to, I know the fire department will be ecstatic about that. So we have a new elevator, so for the public.
Go back to the slide with the overtime. What is the justification for the overtime?
The overtime was for travel needed to and from house for transporting inmates. They used deputies that were not on duty. There was, and I don't know if any of the sheriff's office is here, they can explain, but this was overtime above and beyond what they were budgetarily authorized for. So essentially we took budgeted overtime, divided it by 12, which gives you their monthly overtime amount, and this is the amount over that. The jailers who went to work at the facilities we housed inmates included additional times on each shift to travel to and from those different facilities. I believe Bertie County was a facility that the inmates were housed in for a good amount of time. So that was the additional time. I've got a figure on here of almost 1,200 hours each month. And the next question you may ask is, how many employees is that? And when I ran it for the first 2 months, it 1,200 hours each month was divided up amongst 50 employees. So, you know, the question you might have is, well, was this a few employees working outrageous hours? But it looks like they divided those up pretty proportionate amongst their employee pool. That was also for 3 months. The sheriff's office and jailers work on a 28-day period, so a matter of 161 hours, I think. So once they get over 161, that's when overtime starts.
Let's see, the facilities that took the prisoners, we put employees from the jail in, normal jailers in those facilities.
My understanding is yes, we were required to, once we have a certain amount of inmates in a facility, we're required to staff that facility with our own employees.
Commissioner Booth.
So let me ask one more question. So we're going to pay for the staffing, and then we're going to pay so much a day to the facility. We're going to pay the full board to the facility for keeping the inmate in there.
Yes, sir.
Why is that?
I don't know. I can't answer that. I know that's part of the agreement that they'll house our inmates, but once, and I wish the chief deputy was here, but because I'm not quite sure what that number is, but once those number meets a threshold, we're required to provide a certain amount of staffing.
We're required by the state statutes?
That, no. I believe there's an interlocal agreement with each facility. My understanding is there's an interlocal agreement, but the majority of those were in the Bertie Correctional Facility, which is a state facility.
Well, and I don't mind providing the extra people, but, I mean, there's something wrong with having to pay full bore and provide extra staff, too, because if they have a facility sitting there, obviously that staff should be staffed for, if you will, their capacity. So.
But I don't think it always is, and that puts that burden back on the county that they're providing the service to, so they won't have to hire additional staff. That's what they're doing.
And before I let Commissioner Booth go, let me interject this to you as well, because our meals still come from here, and we have to take them there. And then the other thing is, if somebody's in, let's say you got inmates, if they had some in Lenore, some in Pamlico, as well as Bertie, and anytime if an inmate had to go to the ER or anything.
Yeah, they had to haul them.
The officers had to come from here, go there, and take them. And then they have all the time that they spend at the ER with them. and then take them back, and then come back to Beaufort County. So that's a lot of your problem, and I can say these things, I'm in the courthouse. It's just like mornings that they have court, the ones who are in the North County, if they have to be here at 9:30, that means the officers have to come in earlier to go get them, and a lot of times when they get to the different facilities, they don't have them ready, so then they have to wait. So this whole thing has been somewhat of a nightmare, so, but I just wanted to interject that, but.
Can I ask one question?
Yeah.
So you're saying if you have a jail and it's off facility and it's located somewhere else, then there's going to be an additional cost, and it's irrevocable. There's no way to get around it, to transport them, move them, take them different places. Further they are away from standard facilities, the more it's going to cost.
Yeah. Okay. Commissioner Booth?
Just for clarification, Jim, the numbers that you have up here, $63,482, that is the excess overtime. Then you said that we also have overtime for a 12-month period, and we divide it. So this is, so that overtime actually costs us more or less? Which was it?
This is the additional amount needed above what we had a budgetary authority
already allocated.
To. Yes, sir.
So then, if we have allocated, how much more? I know six. How much had we allocated to start with overtime?
We're going to get to the budget amendments later, and my budget amendments for the month directly correlate with these expenses here. Mm-hmm. And I broke it out like we did in the past, like I was asked to do for the new year, where we show the original appropriation, the amount of the requested amendment. So to answer your question, the original budget for sheriff's office overtime was $90,000.
Okay.
The amount of this, that $63,000 that's attributed to the sheriff's office is $44,484. The additional $18,998 is for the jailers. So the majority of this overtime is actually for the sheriff's office employees.
So we already allocate in our annual budget, we already allocate overtime.
Yes, sir.
So this is $63,482 above what we allocate.
Yes, sir.
That's what I want.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Chairman.
Go ahead.
Christina.
Yes.
How much did the switchgear end up costing?
I had a contract with Watson Electric for not to exceed for $20,000.
So it's $20,000, and it's all new now?
It's all new.
All new. You still have it in the same cabinet?
We use the same, yes.
Enclosure?
We attached a new enclosure to the face of the cabinet where we pulled the old breakers out, and then we mounted a new square D panel on
okay.
that same
you got square
frame.
D now. Mm-hmm. Okay. This also addresses all concerns with the courthouse in relation to the switch gear also?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions?
I have
a question. Brent.
You're going to have to refresh my memory on this, but it seems like I remember doing this. When we, as a group of commissioners, went in and viewed the jail, and this was before we had a problem in there, I noticed that the shower was running continuously all the time. When we come back to our next commissioner's meeting, I made a motion that we replace that shower, and I think it was $40,000 to replace that particular shower. It could have been 20, I'm not quite sure. But what happened to that money that we allocated for that shower?
I believe that was done prior to the end of the past fiscal year, and Ms. Smith and Ms. Ross went and visited another facility, I believe in Franklin County, to get
right.
some ideas on using those stainless steel showers. And I think they felt like we could accomplish something better by doing what they did here rather than spending the $40,000. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. That was my understanding. Not that it was not for the actual fixtures at that point in time. That was for the actual shower enclosures.
Right.
And so what we did in the painting of the jail, we went down and sanded down to the metal and reprimed, and the CMU shower, we went back with a special type of paint
and
did that.
You and I had just a brief conversation last Friday in Mr. Woodruff's office, and I asked you about the plumbing, and you said that all the plumbing was either fixed or in line to fix.
Yes, sir.
And I heard today that we had, still had...
One shower. Yes, sir, and that's...
One shower, that's all we got.
As far as I'm aware, and that's what I stated there, I may have spoken with some of you last week and told you that all of the plumbing had been repaired, because that was the information that I was given, and when there was a walkthrough, it all worked. But as we discussed at a previous meeting, the plumbing is a continual issue, and it will be. And we will just continue to work with that because of the layout of the existing facility and the cost to go in and to totally retrofit every single fixture and every single shower in there would be a great expense. It is something that we plan to look at to determine what's the best alternative, but it has not been the time to do that in the past couple of months.
How do you rate the future reliability of the plumbing going forward? Just continuous?
There will be issues. The severity of the issues and the quantity of the issues, it's difficult to determine at this point.
And you're the only one that fits down the aisle to get to them.
I only go a few in, though. But it's very tight quarters. It's very limited to who can go in and to work on the fixtures. I do fit, but I prefer not to be in there.
I have one more question.
Yes, sir.
Come September the 10th.
Tomorrow.
Prisoners supposedly go in. I hope that's tomorrow.
That was our goal, but that will not be the case. We are still waiting for paperwork to be finalized and to be given to the judge.
But the plumbing will be adequate when the prisoners return.
The plumbing will be adequate. There may still be small issues that the detention officers will have to address, but the plumbing will be adequate for them.
And it'll be much improved.
Very much improved.
Yeah. Well, I'm concerned about the plumbing issue, so, you know, there shouldn't really be any addressing of plumbing issues in the judge's order, if based on what you're telling me.
From the conversations I've had with Judge Sermon, he's just asking nothing above and beyond what typically would be done for the plumbing. He is not requiring.
Well,
I think we'll be having that discussion in closed session later in the meeting to get feedback on that.
All right. What about the ventilation? Are there still issues with the ventilation?
There are still issues in the nurses' area and the dryer area, and that is what we've just received approval from DHHS today verbally that we will be addressing very quickly.
What are they going to allow you to do?
To put in transfer grills, and we'll also add an additional supply duct in the nurses' station. So they are allowing us to do that.
That problem is resolved. And when do you think that will be repaired and in service?
They are starting the work, but in order to order the exhaust fan, possibly, I would say 2 weeks max, it should be in place. Hopefully less time than that.
So, and we don't have to use the laundry, as I understand it, until that is done. So we can use outside laundry, and then when that's done, we start our laundry up.
Yes, sir. The sheriff's office is prepared to utilize the laundry service to get the inmates back in.
Okay. Anything further from anyone else? Thank you, Mrs. Smith.
Next is the last week, the jail committee that was appointed by the board at the last monthly meeting met and indicated that they would like for me to proceed with getting some testing that work done on a potential site on the County Chalkawinage property. And so I advised them that we would need to discuss this tonight for the full board to authorize that.
Is there a motion? Do we have a motion? Is there a second?
Sir.
Okay. Discussion?
Yes, I have. I'd like to make this statement concerning the jail and the building of it. I have major concerns of how we are proceeding with the jail situation. I know my concerns by what I view as a majority of Beaufort County. As I travel the county and talk to my fellow citizens, the number of items discussed is the jail. I have taken so many phone calls that I can't even keep count of them. And the same thing, the jail is their concern. This issue is very complicated. I have reached the conclusion that the best way to handle the jail situation is to carry it directly to the citizens in the form of a referendum. I understand we as county commissioners do not have the authority to take this action unless we have the backing of the General Assembly. Therefore, today I took liberty to contact Senator Bill Cook and State Representative Michael Speciale regarding this matter. In the terms of dollars that is being proposed to build a new jail is comparable to the millions spent in the school bond. The people had a say in that, and I feel they should have a say whether we build a jail or not. I would like to make a motion that we bring this matter of building a new jail to the citizens in a form of a referendum of a yes-no vote in the May 2014 primary. Thank you.
Second. We already have one motion and one second on the floor.
Okay.
So we'll deal with that one first.
Okay.
All right. All in favor of the original motion, raise your right hand.
How much money is in that motion? Nobody said how much money.
All opposed?
I'm opposed. But how much money is it? I didn't hear an amount of money. We voted an open-ended.
Yeah, we did not specify, but I would say 10,000 or less, I would imagine.
Well, as long as the motion has got to say how much money you're appropriating. I mean, we're not the Washington, D.C.
The motion to have Randy to go over there and video the jail didn't have a price tag to it, did it?
You could have asked. I'm asking. See, that's different.
No, it's you.
I'm asking. You didn't ask. If you didn't ask, that's your problem.
Yeah.
I'm asking. How much money are you spending? He says not more than $10,000, right?
If it's more than 10, I'll come back to the board.
Yeah, okay. Then your motion not to exceed $10,000.
I will. Mm-hmm. Well, he just did it for me.
Okay.
Yeah, if he's going to do that, that's fine.
Let's all play by the same rule.
Yeah.
All right. Now, it's pertaining to Commissioner Brand's motion. We have a motion and a second. Any further discussion?
Yeah, there's discussion on it. The Commissioner Brand is entirely correct. In that we're getting ready to spend at a minimum $20 million that this board knows about, and Lord knows how much more each year in operating expenses, because all the operating expenses have not been put into this thing yet. And I, like him, everywhere I go, the topic of conversation, matter of fact, it's not a topic of conversation, it's an objection. Why are you doing something like that? Doesn't make any sense. And the voters and the taxpayers have a right to have a say in this issue, because you're taking $20 million of their money and spending it. And I was hoping that the legislature would fix this in this session of the legislature, but I have not seen anything yet that makes an absolute requirement. I'm sure there may be something in there somewhere that we might could land on that will require a referendum, but the taxpayers need to have a say when their money is being wasted like this.
Yeah, I got something to say, too. Okay. I may be reiterating what's already been said, but I think it bears reiteration. Years ago, we did the bond referendum to build these schools that some feel that we didn't need. I feel that way. But at least we let the people have a vote on it. We had to, because whenever you spend that amount of money, it is prudent and wise to go before the people and ask them, are they willing to spend that kind of money through a bond referendum? Now, for whatever reason, the General Assembly, years ago, before the Republicans took over, they elected to do this without the vote of the people. So now we're going to have to go through some special avenues to get our representatives to give us a local bill so that we can go back to the way it used to be if they can't get it done. I think they'll be able to get it done, but they had some big issues last long session. They'll have to do it in the short session if they can. Now, the reason for doing this is an argument needs to be made why we build a jail 6 miles away from the center of the county seat. Now, I've given reasons why we shouldn't do it. Commissioner Brin's given reasons why we shouldn't do it. Lord knows Commissioner Richardson's given rather astounding reasons why we shouldn't do it. But I really haven't heard a good argument why we should spend this amount of money to put our jail in a location that is 6 miles away from the county seat. So I think if we can get Bryn's motion passed, then you guys would have the opportunity to make that argument to the people. And that's very important that you do that with this amount of money on the line.
Okay. Anything further? All in favor of Commissioner Bryn's motion, raise your right hand.
Put your hand. Oh, favor of the motion. Yeah, I'm in favor of the motion.
All opposed? Okay, it failed. 3-4.
Okay, I'd like to make a statement. I'm going to resign from the jail committee. I will not be a part of anything that jams something down your throat like that. I just will not be a part of it.
We accept your resignation.
Thank you.
Commissioner Belcher will put you in his slot. Okay, next item.
The last.